The a7R IV is a 60 megapixel camera that has a special 240 megapixel mode called pixel shift. And I've been doing some side-by-side testing and the results are really, really shocking. Let's take a look at them first. If you're interested in buying the a7R IV, you can get it at this link here. If you're interested in renting it, when it's available, you can head to sdp.io/rent. Those are our partners at Lens Rentals. Use the coupon code Northrup15. And if you just want to sell all your gear used, our partner KEH can help you out with that at sdp.io/KEH. First comparison, the Sony a7R IV 240 megapixel mode versus the iPhone 10. This is the iPhone on the left, 12 megapixels with the a7R IV 240 megapixels on the right. Yeah, so you 240 megapixels does get you a little more detail out of it, right? But this is 2:1. So if you're 2:1 at 4K, if you're watching at 1080p, you'd be seeing this at 1:1. Let's just zoom in to 4:1 because we can actually see intense amount of detail here. Like on the iPhone, you can see there's some kind of gear there on the camera, but here you can see the individual notches on the gear and how they connect to the other gear. You can read flash right here and distance and all the different numbers on the dial. The detail is pretty incredible. So the iPhone has less detail. That seems obvious, right? And now a whole bunch of angry people on the internet are like, oh, it's not the gear that matters, it's the photographer that matters. Nobody really needs 240 megapixels. Like, okay, fine. But just before you become a bummer and rain on our parade, we're just trying to have fun. It's cool, right? It's cool. Or maybe you want to make huge prints or something. We're going to do an actual comparison of these images at different print sizes and show people them in the real world to see if people can perceive the differences or how big it has to be before they start to perceive the differences. So subscribe to see that. I'm going to take a few minutes and talk about what pixel shift is and how it works. First, Sony did not invent this technology. Panasonic, Pentax, Olympus, they've all had different variations of this. But the four-shot pixel shift takes four different images, moving the sensor by one pixel at a time so that every single pixel gets red, green, and blue color information. So standard four-shot pixel shift, like we had in the a7R III, does not technically increase resolution, though it does increase detail and it does reduce noise. But with the a7R IV, they're now introducing a 16-shot mode, which takes four of those four stacked image shots. The difference is each one of those four images initially gathers the full color information for every pixel in the sensor. It will then shift the pixel by half a pixel down and repeat that process. It then shifts it half a pixel to the right and half a pixel down and to the right, ultimately creating four times as much resolution. Now, that doesn't mean you're going to see four times as much detail because there are other limiting factors. Like in landscapes, you would have atmospheric conditions limiting you. The optics of the lens are going to limit you. And obviously the pixels overlap a little bit, so they're not quite the same as having a 240 megapixel sensor. But as we just saw, the results are pretty intense. Let's take a look at what the a7R IV looks like versus the Sony a7 III, a 20 megapixel camera with an AA filter. Zooming into 2:1, the differences are really, really obvious. If we zoom into 4:1, those of you on smartphones should have an easier time really seeing the difference. You can see here, there's just so much more detail out of the 240 megapixel camera. And this is with a 16 to 35 zoom lens. This is not some super sharp, expensive prime. It's just the lens that you would probably actually be using for this type of photography. So it could be limited by the lens optics. We could certainly get more dramatic results out of a higher quality lens. But you can see, even at this difference in resolution, you definitely can benefit from having more than 24 megapixels. None of these numbers here are even readable, whereas they're just crystal clear on the a7R IV. Take a moment to plug my books. Stunning Digital Photography, the number one photography book in the world, has over 14 hours of video built into it, and the ebook is less than 10 bucks. We also have video books covering Photoshop and Lightroom and the art and science of photography. You can search Amazon for Tony Northrup to find my stuff, or head to sdp.io/store. Let's take a look at the a7R IV versus its predecessor, the a7R III. And these are going to be the pixel shifted file from the a7R IV versus the standard 42 megapixel file from the a7R III. This is the same scene zoomed in. Here you can see the extra 42 megapixels did give us more detail than the A7 III. You start to be able to make out some of those numbers, but compared to the 240 megapixel file, there's just no comparison. This is so, so much clearer. Look at this other dial over here. You can see each of these little ridges, which just kind of get lost here. We have some raw ray. You see how like the rainbow effect is happening here, even though it's not actually there. That is the pixel shift process eliminating false color. And this dial here, you can see the numbers are very clear, whereas they're just completely lost in this fairly tiny little camera. Here's a more fair comparison. This is the Sony a7R IV versus the Sony a7R IV without pixel shift. So this is the 60 megapixel native a7R IV files versus those pixel shifted files to find out whether or not it's really worth to turn on the 240 megapixel mode. The 60 megapixel file on the left, you can see it is starting to extract more detail. We can start to make out that this is a 7, but still, 240 megapixels is definitely extracting dramatically more detail out of the scene. Here, you still can't make out these words like distance right there when they're just crystal clear on the 240 megapixel file. I'm really amazed at just how much detail this lens has been able to resolve. But what if you have an a7R III and you are using the current pixel shift mode? Are you going to see that much more detail out of the a7R IV with the pixel shift? Let's find out. You can see pixel shift on the a7 R3 does improve detail, but we still can't read that word distance, which is so clear on the a7 R Mark IV with the 240 megapixel files. These numbers, again, quite clear here and just completely lost, but because it is pixel shift, the a7 R3 files have eliminated the false color that we saw here. There are a bunch of problems with using pixel shift. It is really, really hard. And I want to make this point because I don't want anybody dropping $3,500 on a new camera unless you know exactly what you're going to get and how it's going to perform in real world situations. I've seen major news outlets saying that this would be a dream camera for landscape photographers specifically because of pixel shift. That is not true. This is not for landscapes. You will not find any amount of success with the vast majority of landscape scenes. Just as an example, this is my backyard, but let's zoom in to just a tree here. You can see this shot's taken at 1/200th of a second. It is not a long exposure, but look at the crazy amount of just errors that we get in the pixel shift process. Even with a fast shutter speed, that's because the tree leaves move in this, there was no wind, but still tree leaves move a little bit and it creates just crazy artifacts like that. The same is going to happen in any scene that has water. So let's look at the water here. Yeah, see, just weird little diagonals and crosshatches, and the effect is so difficult to deal with that I took something like 20 shots in New York City, and zero of them turned out. I could not get a single shot in New York City to turn out, and I'm sure other people will succeed at that. I don't know if it was the cars driving past and shaking the tripod just a little bit. I was on the sidewalk. I did another shot indoors, but I was on the ground floor, and maybe there's like a subway going underneath and shaking things, or maybe the entire buildings are moving. But every single photo I took in New York City had this type of artifacting happening. I only got successful results when I came into my own home with a very heavy tripod. I put the camera on a 5-second delay. A 2-second delay was not enough. There was still a little bit of shutter shake that ruined the pictures. I had to be in environments with zero wind, no ground movement. And I want to make the point, you cannot review the results after you take it. You can't check them in camera. You have to bring the files. It takes 16 separate files. You have to bring them into your computer and run them through Sony software, and then you can review the results. So while you're in the field, you don't know if you got the shot because there are so many things that can go wrong. All you can do is take a lot of pictures and just hope that one of them turned out. So every time I do this, I routinely need to take about 10 pictures to have any level of confidence that I get one. Each 16 shot photo is 2 gigabytes per shot. So if you're like me and you take a series of 10 just to make sure you get one, you're now looking at about 20 gigabytes per scene. That's a lot. So if you have a 64 gig card, maybe you could do 3 separate scenes. These are big files. So this is not for everybody. This is not for most people. But the results are pretty shocking. And if you want to be able to produce the biggest possible pictures, if you want to be able to crop tightly, if you're doing product photography or still life photography, and you really want to wow your clients, there, I've never seen anything that can match what this camera with the 240 megapixel pixel shift can do. It is amazing. Any follow-up questions, answer down below. Check the description and I will link to these files so you can play with them yourself. If you want to check out my photography books covering stunning digital photography, Photoshop, Lightroom, camera and gear buying, or the art and science of photography, check out our store at sdp.io/store. They all start at 10 bucks. Or you can just go to Amazon and look up my name, Tony Northrup, and check out reviews. Finally, subscribe to see our print test where I will print these out at varying scales up from 8x10 to very large and run them past just normal, regular people and see if they can perceive the differences so we can actually see whether those megapixels actually matter. And we're also going to have a full A7R4 review where we compile all of the results from these different ongoing tests so you can decide whether or not you want it. If you want to rent something, sdp.io/rent, coupon code Northrup15. And of course, our partners KEH will buy, sell, or fix your camera gear. Thanks so much. Bye.